Hello and welcome back to another one of my videos. Some weeks ago, I shared this free GB serial monitor program with my viewers and asked them to give some feedback on how to improve it. If you missed this video, you can find a link in the description. During this video, I will go through some of the suggestions that were made in the comment section of the previous video. And I will also show some of the new features that I implemented in the GB serial monitor based on those comments. But before we start, I want to thank all my viewers who posted a positive comment on my previous video. I really appreciate each and every one of them. So here we go with the suggestions that were made. ACLG and a lot of other viewers suggested to put the send and receive text boxes on the same tab, so you don't have to change tabs during testing. I think this is a legit suggestion and I totally agree. So I started shifting the various components around from one tab to the other. And after a final lineup, I ended up with this main data monitor screen. The other tab is now used for setting up the data behavior. On the data monitor tab, it's now possible to send data and directly check the response from the serial port without switching tabs. Bernard Hoffman suggested that when you change the view format, all the data in the data received text box should be changed to the new format. This could be a nice feature, so you can check the same data in multiple formats. However, for now I decided to skip this suggestion. The reason is that I want to change the interrupt data receive handler code to increase the performance. If I take a high input data rate, meaning a constant byte stream with only 100 microseconds between each byte, and select the binary output, the program becomes non-responsive. This change to increase the performance has some common grounds with the suggestion that Bernard Hoffman made. So I will keep this suggestion in mind for future improvements. The other suggestion from Bernard Hoffman is to implement a new line after an adjustable number of received bytes. Compared to the previous suggestion, this was relatively easy to implement, and I can understand why this feature could be handy. So I ended up with this extra setting in the data handling tab. As an example, I can set 5 characters in a single line. When I now send the complete alphabet, it's neatly divided into lines with each 5 characters. This feature gives the possibility to filter the incoming data if the number of bytes are always the same. Pop-Tart McJelly suggested the use of macros. This might be useful for a future version of the GB serial monitor. So please let me know in the comment section below what app you are referring to so I can have a look at the macro functions that the app is using. Marion Soban, and please forgive me if I spelled your name wrong, suggested to add a timestamp as the use in the Arduino IDE. To be honest, I never used the timestamp function before, so I first had to figure out how it works. In short, the timestamp feature of the Arduino IDE adds the system time before the first byte that is received after a next line and carriage return byte combination. Okay, this was also relatively easy to implement, and you can find the timestamp checkbox here. I only made it available under the normal view mode, as this makes the most sense. When hexadecimal, decimal, or binary is selected, the timestamp is not available. If you really need this timestamp functionality while working on, for example, hexadecimal, please let me know in the comments section below. And in case you wonder, this timestamp is also stored in the log file. When I now connect an Arduino that sends the text "Hello World" every second and check the timestamp checkbox, you can see that the timestamp is working. The last comment that I want to discuss is the serial plotter function that some of you are missing. And yes, I hope to implement some form of a plotter in the GB serial monitor, but that will be something for another video in the future. A feature that I added myself for this version is the Data Terminal Ready Control Signal, or DTR for short. Most Arduino boards use this signal to create a reset of the microcontroller. This way, the bootloader is activated and it is possible to upload a new program. Also, when you open the serial monitor, the microcontroller is reset because of this DTR signal. This is not always the desired behavior when you want to keep the microcontroller running. That is why I created this checkbox. When checked, the Data Terminal Ready Control Signal is set high when the COM port is opened. This way the microcontroller is reset when you connect the GB serial monitor, giving you a clean start of the microcontroller program. If you leave the checkbox empty, the Data Terminal Ready Control Signal will stay low and the microcontroller is not reset. And that brings us to the end of this video. Again, if you have any recommendations for the GB serial monitor, please leave them in the comment section below so I can try to implement your suggestions. If you want to download the GB serial monitor, you can find a link in the description. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to hit the like button if you think this GB serial monitor program is useful.